Oh, this video is so funny. Okay, Will's Way says, do people progress to level 5 from 4 after losing or detaching from their ego? It's more like 3 to 4, I think, is a detachment from the ego, because you realize, like, oh my gosh, like, I'm a part of the ecosystem like everyone else. Like, I'm not special. No one is special. We're all just doing our best. And then 4s are really frustrated with it, because you have to let go of the version of yourself you created your whole life, usually. And then 5s, I think, are at peace with it. So 4s are like, oh my God, I have to let go of all the things I thought were important. Like, oh my gosh, I have to care. Like, I used to care what Ben Shapiro thought about the world. And now I'm like, why the fuck did I even care what Ben Shapiro thought about the world? Or like what Jordan Peterson said, or what like anyone said on the internet. Like, who fucking cares? They're just like me, only they look different and they're just saying shit. Like, we're all just doing that. You know what I mean? Like, what? And then I realized, like, oh, I cared because I thought it was going to impact the greater world somehow. Or I thought, like, if we just did this, this would matter. If I just did this, like, this would matter. If I just did, no. Like, people are doing their best. Like, this idea of like world peace and like utopia, all of that. I'm over it. Like, I'd rather have freedom and chaos. Freedom and chaos any day, you know? Okay. Should we watch this one? Sure.
So this video, Bella D, talking about the struggle of not being able to buy designer clothing in high school is going viral. Make sure you watch to the end.
I never growing up had anything designer. You know, my mom wouldn't let me. I think I got my first pair of Louboutins when I graduated high school. It makes me emotional, actually, because I'm like so happy in this picture. Like, for the first time in, I think, like my whole adult life, here I feel just at ease, like happy. I'm able to work. I feel good about myself. I felt beautiful. And compared to the girl that I see, like in the beginning, she was so sad and she is so content and happy. And I love that to see that progression. It's like I feel blessed that I made it out alive of that mental state that I was in for so many years. So it feels good. And we love.
Wow, that was so relatable.
So, this is what I mean by bubbles. So, her life was my life, only I was poor and she was rich. So, my version of growing up poor middle class was like being able to like my mom couldn't afford to buy me real Uggs, so she bought me Costco Uggs. It would have been really cool to have real Uggs, because the popular girls definitely made fun of me for having Costco Uggs, but then Britney didn't genuinely see the difference between Costco Uggs and real Uggs. But the world was telling me I should see a difference, and I just didn't understand it. And so I felt shitty. But in her world, if you don't have Louis Vuitton, whatever, before, see, I don't even want to say designer names, before high school graduation, you're a loser. So it's the same. So I, from a poor person's perspective, can be like, fucking shut up, bitch. But from a spiritual perspective, actually feel like she just had the same life I had, only she had a different version of it. So when I say rich people and poor people are the same, this is what I mean. Like, I think they're all the same. Her mom also encourages eating disorders and like is really shitty to her. So I feel like it's all the same. We have standards that our circle, our group is telling us we have to live by. And when we don't fulfill that, we feel like shitty, right? That's ultimately why it's the same. Does that make sense? What do you guys think about that? Joy says, good for her. Miss Alicia says, this is the kind of shit I just stopped caring about after becoming introspective. G says, ew, stop. Madeline says, I'm cringing so hard. Thoughtbug says, I've heard you mention before something like, this person's a 3 with a little 4-ness. Are the boundaries separating the levels kind of blurry? Yeah, because 3 is like this bridge where like you can be a 2 going from bubble to bubble. Like, oh, I'm conservative, I'm liberal, I'm leftist. These are all 2 bubbles. Not all of them are as introspective as they think they are. They're only introspective in relation to other people. All of them are reacting. They're reactionary to the world around them. They are not introspective about the world around them. They think they are, but they're not. They're reacting. Then when you leave the bubbles, you either cut the string or whatever, or you're on a bridge, you're making a decision about, okay, what if I go further than this? What if I've already left the conservative bubble, left the liberal bubble, left the leftist bubble? Well, what bubble is next? What if the bubble that's next is not another one that's been established, but the one that says maybe we're more than this altogether, or maybe we're nothing? And that's what's so beautiful, is like maybe we are just like living in an ecosystem. And so we don't need to have these, like, this, listen to her. She's crying over not having Louis Vuittons. Like, what is she, fucking Carrie from Sex and the City? It's like, this is her value system. In the same way I had a shitty value system when I was younger. Or, like, people always have subjective value systems. I don't mean to say shitty, but, like, in regards to introspection, like, who the fucking cares about brand shoes, bro? Who fucking cares about fucking Louis Vuitton? Like, you know what I mean? Unless you, like, it's valuable to you, I guess. But, like, maybe you're like, oh, I like them because they're, like, good shoes. Like, sure. Like, I upgraded my wardrobe because I wanted nicer clothes. You know what I mean? But I don't care what brand it is. Like, you know what I mean? But some people really care about that stuff. I just think it's exhausting and it sounds exhausting. But, again, I'm not trying to say that she doesn't feel feelings, right? So in terms of those boundaries, those blurs, like, she would be somebody who could hop between two bubbles. But, like, imagine you're on a bridge and you're like, oh, maybe there's more. You could try to go over, but once you go over to four, you can't go back to a two. So once you're a four, you can't really care about Louis Vuitton in the same way you did before. Like, it's so hard. It's like, who cares, bro? Like, once you're past a certain moment, so then you become at peace with that and you're a five. It's like a five goes, okay, cool. No problem. I've accepted people are going to be people and I will adapt and I will enjoy and I will see the benefits of being alive. You know, and I'm an adult. I'm smart. I could kill myself tomorrow if I didn't want to do it anymore. But I'm not going to do that because I'm not depressed anymore. I don't want to die. And frankly, life is pretty good, but life is only good now. Somebody on Destiny's chat called me a privileged white woman who thinks life is great because her life has been great. She's like, they were like, mom and dad probably paid for all your bills growing up. And I'm just like, that's so interesting that now, because my life is together and I probably present that way. Like, I probably present like somebody who grew up with money, or maybe I do present like a white spoiled woman who like didn't come from an immigrant family, like, and struggled. Like, I probably do look that way. So I've noticed in two bubbles, people will remain looking homeless, poor, disenfranchised in order not to lose the respect of their communities. But if we wanted our communities to be healthy, we would push them to being healthy, getting better. Yes, look like the rich, privileged person that actually does have a nice life, because isn't that what we want for everybody? And like, no, it's not. Like, people want people to suffer with them. And so they don't trust them. I had somebody say to me, like, your depression isn't like my depression. You don't have any idea what it's like to be this depressed. I was like, okay, like, I don't know how to explain to them, like, because I got better after 20 years, that for them, they just don't believe me that I could have been as depressed as them. But I get that, because when I was really depressed for all that time and I wanted to die all the time and I was manic and having borderline episodes, yeah, I didn't think anyone really got it unless they were exhibiting signs or symptoms of depression. And so I get it. Like, I can't even be mad. Like, I'm a little offended, but like, I'm not that mad about it. Cause I'm like, yeah, I get it. Like, it's hard to see me and think that I've ever struggled when my life looks so fabulous now. You know what I mean? But like, everybody struggles on a spectrum. Everybody. And I don't want to play a game with people about like who struggled the most, unless there's like a humbling that needs to happen or something. I don't know. Let's see. Have you ever heard of Brian Cady? I have not. I don't know who that is. Raven says that she needs physical things. Honestly, I feel bad for her. I guess. I mean, it's hard to feel. I mean, I guess I do. I always feel bad for people who want more out of life but don't seem to have the tools to get it, especially if they're in positions of power. I'm just like, girl, you have money and looks. Like, figure it out. Get a, like, a fucking, I don't know, medicine man or something. Like, read a book. I don't know. Blue Hill said, are fives inherently confident? Is that the difference between fours and fives? No, twos are extremely confident. But fours, it depends on the four. I just think there's a lot of, for me, four was the hardest stage for me. For some people, it wasn't as hard. But like, a lot of people feel like they have to kill a part of themselves off, which you do to have to grow. Some people feel like four is depressing because like you've built this whole life as a two and then you went on this journey as a three and then the people around you didn't go with you. So then it feels like you have to abandon the world you've had in order to go to four. But the irony is like once you're five, like you can fit back into the two world really easily. It just, as a four, you just don't want to. It's just so tedious. It's so much more But you really have to have a moment. You have to have a significant life-changing moment between 3, 4, 5 to really know that it's happened. Because if I get you in a conversation and I put you in a corner and I really challenge you, you might realize that you're still a 2 who thinks they're like figured it out because you're nihilistic. A 2 nihilist is different than a 4 nihilist. Like, and a 5 is just okay with the unknown. Like, 2s really want to know. Don't you want to know if there's a God? Don't you want to know if you're going to hell? Yeah, sure. But I also want to know why there's a lump in my breast. And I want to know why I like feet so much. And I want to know why I'm attracted to gamer boys. And I want to know a lot of things. But, like, it's all the same to me. It's all on equal knowing. And then I choose out of those things my priorities of what makes me me. And that comes with meditation, looking at the self. What is my core self? Who am I? Taking it apart, understanding myself. You know what I mean? Yeah. But Rip says, I don't think her point was that it was a struggle to not grow up with designer clothes, just that she was excited about wearing them. I mean, enough to cry, though. And I watched that whole interview. She goes through the flip book, you know, the Vogue or, I don't know, Vanity Fair. I don't know which one it is, but they go through their photos and time. And don't get me wrong. That's what I mean. Like, I see the Kardashians and I know the Kardashian story. Like, they're normal people like you and me who just, like, they're 2A thinkers, though. So they know it's all meaningless. They know they're pretty sure, like, all these religions and racial divides and everything is all bullshit made up by a bunch of people with money and time on their hands and poor people who are too stupid to know better. And then they all get into this, like Whoopi. On The View being, like, canceled because she said something about Jews. It's, like, it's so fucking retarded. Like, she's stupid for thinking Jews aren't seen by Hitler as a race. And then everyone else is stupid for canceling her because she has a different opinion and different way of seeing things. But Black Americans are also very arrogant about racism because they experience it as the main character against white people. While the rest of us are just sitting here watching them do their fucking bullshit together. And that's the problem, because Black people have suffered so much in this country that they harbor a lot of that, like, generational trauma, but they forget you're not the only people who suffer from racism. And because they're Americans, trust me, you're not Black first. You're definitely American first. And I can tell because of your attitudes. And I can tell because I'm always going to be American first because of my attitudes. Immigrant background or not, being raised in America or not, we got American attitudes because people aren't like us around the world. So I think we have to remember that. Like, being raised here is an extremely specific bubble. It's very America. You know what I mean? It's very much an American bubble. You know? Let me see. Love the Ugg talk. Love everyone that got Cugs. Cugs? Oh, is that like Costco? That's funny. What do you know who the YouTuber Papa Gut is? I would be so interested to hear your take on him, especially through the lens of your levels. I did check out Papa Gut. He seems really introspective and interesting. I was getting like 3 energy from him for sure. I was getting like a lot of introspection. He didn't capture my attention. So I watched like 1 or 2 videos and I just remember thinking like, I don't really want to watch more of this. And I couldn't figure out if it was the way his page was set up or if he just came from such a different culture from me. I didn't really want to go through that with him or the way he, like, I don't know what it was, but I'm sure if I watch, like, I did this with Destiny too. When I first watched Destiny, I was like, I don't want to watch this guy. And then my sister was like, no, you're going to like Destiny. And I waited years. I was like, nah. And then a girl in my Discord is like, Brittany, watch Destiny. He's a total 3. I was like, nah. And then finally I started watching him and I saw him with ABBA and I like ABBA a lot. So I was like, okay. I like ABBA and Preach. I love their channel. So I was like, okay. So then I started to check out Destiny and I was like, okay, I'm more able to handle this canter, like this tone, whatever you want to say. The way he speaks is just very specific. So I'm like, okay, it's like sometimes you just have to be open to it. So I will probably revisit Papa Gut. But as of right now, I mean, obviously introspective from what I saw, obviously trying to challenge his bubbles, which I'm here for ultimately. Let me see. Okay. Da-da-da-da-da. Okay, so from now on, guys, I will probably go through maybe a couple of these videos, but I'm also going to open it up to anything you guys want to ask. Catherine says you're the first person to have the same take on this clip. Everyone else just says she's privileged. Well, it's really hard because my initial gut was like, what a fucking rich bitch. And then after I said that out loud, I was like, oh, that's not very nice. And then I was like, well, what does that mean? And then I realized, like, well, it's just the same thing. I meet rich people all the time, like mega rich people, like guys, rich in a way that my brain can't process. And I'm like, you are so sad. And they're like, I know. And I'm like, why? And they're like, I don't know. And I'm like, well, I think it has to do with introspection. Like, are we all meet like wealthier people and they'll say things to me like, well, how are you so happy and content with your life? And I'm like, how are you not happy and content with your life? And they're like, I don't know, something's missing. And I was like, I have a feeling it's just like family, interpersonal relationships, knowing the self. Like, money's great. Money's great. Money's really good. But it's not everything. It's not. As a person who used to have like $6 in her bank account and moved 40 something times, lived in my car, like did a bunch of things, let me tell you, money is great, but it's not everything. It really isn't. I lived off like $20,000 one year and just like traveled around the United States. And as I was doing it, I was thinking about it. I think it was like 17,000, but it was like a little amount-ish. Like you couldn't do like a lot of things. You could just do your basics because I still have bills to pay. Like $800 a month of that at least was like bills. So like I couldn't even, car payments and insurance payments and gas. Like gas alone was extremely expensive. So it's like, it's interesting to think about having to live off like minimum wage, basically a little under, and then travel and thinking about those things. Like, what did I prioritize? I prioritize like free camping and living and being on BLM lands and like experiences. And like, that's just different. A lot of people can't do that. It was gross. I didn't shower for days on end. There were times I couldn't pee in a bathroom. Like it was messy, girl. Like, you know, but it was worth it. It was worth that challenge. But that's something I needed to do for me. That I think some people called privilege at the time. They would say things like, wow, Brittany, you're so privileged to be able to just like travel and live in a trailer or your car or do things. Like, that's so privileged. And I was like, really? Because in everyone else's head where I was being, they're like, why are you giving up your job of $60,000 a year to do this? And I'm like, I don't know. I think I have to though. So I gave up my job as a nanny and I left and I just did that instead off Patreon, YouTube money, basically. That's how much I was making, basically. And I don't know. Like, for some people, they thought I was, like, privileged. And for other people, they thought I was, like, being homeless. And they just didn't understand. It's hard to look at people and think you know them if you don't have anything in your toolbox to understand them. Compassion means to suffer with. So for people who say they're super compassionate, to look at her and just think like, what a fucking privileged bitch. Like, yeah, that might be your petty thought. I call those my petty thoughts. But my real thoughts don't really believe that. I'm sure she's a nice person. I'm sure she struggles like the rest of us, you know? Yeah. Chance says, watching Miss Hadid made me draw a parallel to people experiencing a similar moment, just in a more dire slash less lavish lifestyle. It comes off as pretentious, but that's literally her bubble. Exactly. She like, it's literally just her bubble. When Logan Paul went up just recently to like the Alps or something, some rich people mountain where billionaires are, he told the kids as like a joke, I guess, but not really. He's like, hey, this isn't reality, bro. This isn't how normal people live. Like a burger was like $85. An expensive burger where I am is like $15. If I paid $15 for a burger and chips, that is expensive. That is a good burger. We have a place in town. Oh, it's so good. It's so good. It's like $15 to $18 a burger and they're so good. It's worth it. But that is expensive, bro. That is an expensive burger to me, but it's so good. All handmade or like not organic, but like, you know, local mom and pop shop. Beautiful. So yeah, just like, you know, the ways to think about things, right? It's like everyone's in a bubble. Like I don't envy her life. Like I genuinely wouldn't want it. Eating disorders and modeling, lame. Definitely not my vibe, bro. Oh, not my vibe. I'll bet five sometimes miss the bliss a two might have. A five misses out on ignorance. So like everything I do, I have to think about if I'm being unethical. So like everyone I sleep with, everyone I have sex with, I have to literally think, am I taking advantage of this person by having sex with them? Am I overthinking this? Am I allowed to have consensual sex with an adult who isn't as introspective as me? Am I ever manipulating the masses, blah, 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 like those types of things. Well, a two just does it thinking like, this is what I should do. And they don't really think about it, which is why a lot of them make mistakes or rape people because they're like, this is how I want to play with consent. And I'm like, ah, versus I just like think and think and think. So like I have the struggle of like, of that for sure. I don't think I have the luxury anymore of being stupid. Like, and I mean that in the nicest way, but like there are women in two bubbles I know who are like, I'll just have a baby, and they'll go get pregnant from random people. And then when it doesn't work out, they'll like have abortions, or like they'll get pregnant and just have a baby because they can. And like, I can't do that. I'm literally not allowed to pretend to be that ignorant anymore. And so like, I'm limited by my own value system because I think that is the less efficient way and moral way to go about having a kid. But I also don't blame a bunch of people in the 80s who had kids when they were poor and in love. It's like, let them be poor and in love, or let them be rich and in love. Let them be like having affairs and having babies if that's really what they think they should be doing at the time. But like, I don't have that luxury. And it's a luxury to be ignorant. It is a luxury for sure. It gets you in trouble, but it also lets you experience parts of life that like, I just genuinely couldn't experience. Like, I can't hate my parents the way I used to, because to hate my parents would mean that I haven't reached the level of introspection that I know I have. Because how could I humanize my parents and then hate them? You know, I think if I was to humanize someone and hate them, like, I don't really hate anyone. Like, I can't think of one person I hate. I don't hate my rapists. I don't hate my stalker. I don't hate my ex who cheated. I don't hate anybody. I'm way too tired and way too at peace with the fact that they, in those moments, did what was self-serving to them. And though I disagree and I'm upset with the impact, I'm less upset with them because I frankly understand, like, really logically, that they just couldn't have done it any differently. Like, they didn't even have the tools to think, I should do this differently. So ultimately, it's like, how mad can I be about people who don't even, they don't even know, bro.